onions first. Put them mixed together. Spices here, there's some turmeric, some black pepper, garlic powder. Thank you. and we sweated off two medium onions diced, and as soon as they were that clear, almost see-through type thing, we added some herbs and spices. I started with oregano, some mixed herbs and some basil, and once they started to waft that delicious smell of theirs, I added some turmeric, some black pepper and some coriander. Mixed that all through, and then I added the meat, minced beef for this one. Once meat was broken down, and you can see that it's got just the right consistency for what I'm using it for, once the meat was broken down, I added a can of crushed tomatoes, half a can of water. You could use beef stock or wine or beer, I don't know, I don't care. Whatever you want to use, but you need that little bit of extra moisture because you want it to simmer down. And three good spoons, maybe four good spoons of tomato paste usually does the trick. And then once you've got all that mixed through, chuck in some beef stock. I use OXO cubes, so two of those would do. And this is the meat for the lasagna. We're just waiting for the pasta to thaw out, and I've got to make the bechamel, which we'll get started on pretty soon. So yeah, this, you simmer it down till it's about this consistency. You don't want it too wet, but you don't want it too dry either, because when we're using homemade pasta for this, and you need the moisture to cook the pasta. To do the bechamel. Okay, this is the fun bit. This is the bechamel. Great Melba butter, big huge one, that's what you want. You want it to melt, but you don't want it to burn. So okay, now we want about 3 cups of sauce, maybe 4. So this is just plain flour. Thank you. I'm a messy cook now. You could do this nice and neat and tidy and slow if you wanted to. But that'll start thickening up again. Starting to smooth out nicely. Start popping in the cheese. Chefs will make you think that this is really hard to do and takes forever, and no, it isn't. Anyone can do it. We have it, one thick cheesy bechamel sauce. How easy is that? Okay, so that gets cool. I want this to cool down a bit before we put the lasagna together. So then we'll take it from there. But you can use the bought sheets. Decide to make your own. It's one cup of flour and one egg with maybe a tablespoon or two of water. And just rub it all together. you'll know if it's too wet or too dry. You can always just add more water or add more flour. Pretty hard to overwork pasta dough, but at some point it will start cracking. This was all fresh made last time I made lasagna. It's been sitting in the freezer ever since, so rolling beans. Thank you. pizza day. You know. He's expecting perfect. Remember, this is homemade. You want it perfect? You store bought. That's that for that part. Now remember, if you want to make your own, it's one cup flour to one egg and one or two tablespoons of water. Out now. Okay, next we put it together. Okay, lasagna. Oop, wrong with this. Thank you. and tasted it. Goodness. Almost finished lasagna. Okay, hang on just a second. Okay, last little bit now is, grated cheese over the top, as much or as little as you like. And I'm using a tasty cheddar. But you can use anything. I do, and I'm the one eating, so. And finally, okay, that goes in the oven. Say 200 degrees for 45 minutes, depending on your oven, less or longer. And we'll come back and see the final product. Okay, so here's the finished product. Yes, Sasha, we know. That is homemade lasagna. From scratch. So, okay, obviously it's a big meal, so serve it with salad or have it on its own. It is absolutely to die for and you'll love it. So, until next time, bye!